Hi guys, this is Bruno from Morley Computer Sales and Repairs. Gonna be assembling this Kronos Metis case into a few bits and pieces. And yeah, so we just did the video unboxing this one and showing it around. So feel free to check it out. Just gonna crack on and start assembling it. Just gonna take this panel, take this as well, so it's out of the way. Just move them somewhere where they won't disturb. Okay, so on this case, I think I'm gonna start with. Da-da-da-da-da. Right, the radiator that I have, it's for two fans, which won't fit in this case, because the PSU goes there, unless I assemble it on the top, which I'm not really keen on doing. Right, let's just crack one and then we'll see how it goes. So, first things first. So I'm gonna get this PSU here, or should we put the motherboard first? That's fine, let's put the PSU. Right, so this is a Kronos FX500W. It's quite a cheap one. Well, it's not modular, as you can see as well. Okay, so we're back assembling this, so we're gonna have to remove the motherboard and the graphics card and some of these cables so you can put the GameMax 600 that we got here. So originally we're gonna put a CPU cooler, so we left the stock AMD brackets, but this one has its own bracket, so we're gonna be having to remove the motherboard to put the backplate on the back and then put it back there. So we'll probably just remove the motherboard and assemble everything here, as we should have done from the beginning, and then we'll put it all back. I started assembling because I wanted to kind of get things done. However, you know, ended up wasting more time because now I have to disassemble part of the work that has been done already. But hopefully it's gonna be worth it. Okay, let's get these screws out. Use this one, be faster. Or maybe not. Thank you. So you need to get the SATA cable for this hard drive. I totally forgot. And now let's take our motherboard out. Let's play with you for a second. Alright, so let's remove this back plate. It's done and it's gone. Now here I'm gonna put the backplate, so the AMD facing the motherboard. I'm just gonna get it there. That's done, quite steady, perfect. So let's lay it out here. Now we have this for this, this. Okay, so okay, now this one. Sure that this is nice and tight and it doesn't move. Don't want to apply too much pressure. This memory is just getting in the way as well. Trying not to apply too much pressure because we might break something and we don't want that after all the work and the money. Okay. Okay. Alright, so now we're going to put this one. It's there, and this one just there. Come on. They all kind of have to enter at the same time because of the alignment. Come on, it's here. Just here we go. Go down. Okay. Go to the bottom, not yet. So let's just push it down. Could go a bit more. Here I go. Now it's at the bottom. Yep, yep. And yeah, okay. Now I got this little four rings we put here and here and the crazy dog. Here and here. And now, because that's not enough, we're gonna add these ones on top and we're gonna tie them in a bit. We're gonna have to disassemble these fans from the side. So we're just putting this kind of in place. Alright, so this one, now pressure in the middle and it just falls down. And here we go. And now I can actually get to them. Oh, ish. Ish. The way that this was designed was not great. Not great at all. Oh, it's tidying up actually. But getting there with this is not gonna be possible. Which means that you're gonna have to do it manually and then use the small. This one. Which is not really the best way to do this. Not at all. Oh, what did we forget? Forgot the thermal paste. Isn't this just great? I'm gonna have to take the whole thing off again. Okay, so let's put this one kind of back in place, just kind of. And let's get our thermal paste. One, two, three, four. Got three there. Where's the last one? Oh, I heard it. It's there. Okay. Okay, that's enough. It's more than enough around it. Okay, and back to it again. So like this, and make sure we're not forgetting anything. No, that's it. Okay, now let's try to put it somehow come on, just go down at the same time. That's okay. Down, 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 down. So now let's put these ones. Like, there's so many easier ways to do this, and they just do it in a, or they make it so it's in the hardest way possible, with so many easier ways to do this. Hopefully it's gonna be worth it. Hopefully. Right, so that's done. So in this case, if we have to tie that up, there's no point taking the fan, so let's just put these fans back. Okay. In place on. Doesn't want to go now. It's the cables that are getting in the way, so let's just pull them. One side at a time. It's still not there. Oh, Right. Looks like they make these so you break it before you actually use it. These two. Like the way that they put these cables here is just ridiculous, to say the least. Okay, that's one. Jesus Christ. This one doesn't seem to be as bad as the other side. Go. Yeah, that looks better. It's still cracking a bit. I'm not entirely convinced it's all in place, but it'll be fine. It's still gonna work anyway. Alright. So let's start with this side then. Let's just try to put this one manually first. Okay. Like, you spend more time assembling the CPU fan than the rest of the computer. It's just ridiculous, really. And then you have to resort to these things. Because they couldn't make it in a way that you can actually reach them. It's just ridiculous. Just goes round and around and around. Finally, it's tidying up now. Yeah, that's enough, that's good. So, we're gonna put it in across. It just keeps going. Okay, now. And that's why you spend a little bit more to get a different CPU cooler. So I would definitely not recommend this one based on the assembly. That's for sure. And the instructions are really bad as well. I spend about 10 minutes or 15 minutes trying to understand what screws are for what. Because they don't tell you, but two of the brackets don't come with screws, and then their screws are inside one of the Intel bags, and now this just feels like I'm just screwing until the universe, because it never finishes, and it's getting really annoying now. these get there? No. What I have to say. Who thought of this? Who thought that assembling this way would be the best way? Seriously, it's just annoying. One thing's for sure, not buying another one of these CPU fans. It just keeps going on and on. What the fuck? You're fucking joking. I feel like I'm gonna damage the motherboard before I even turn it on. It just keeps going. Well, it doesn't seem like it's going anywhere. And it's definitely touching the CPU, so I'm not even gonna try it anymore. Guess that's gonna be enough. So after 5 hours, that's tight enough now. So before we put it, because these cables are quite short, we're just gonna connect them now so it's easier later. So so that's gonna go to the power, so this one is gonna go here eventually. Let's see what we have here. 3, 4. Yeah. Okay, so let's go with this one. Connect it here. Okay. Again, very flimsy. It's gonna come out very easily. And now we're gonna connect. So we have this fan. It and then we have this one. And then we have this one. Okay, that's the three of them connected. Just thinking if I should just connect that straight away. Okay, so let's see this trigger here. And this one I'm gonna connect here like this. And this one here like this. Now these ones are gonna be passed to the back of the computer, so you can put them through here somehow. Maybe like this. So there's a through here, I guess, and then this one we can send it there, and then we're gonna connect it here. CPU fan, okay. Not a big fan of this, but maybe we can hide it somehow. Right, this is done, so let's move some things out of the way if we don't need any more. Different place section. This. This here. This one's gonna disappear. Keep the desk nice and clean so it's easy to work. Can add this memory here now. Maybe rerouting some of the cables through the back one, but I don't think it would look very nice and would put some pressure on the motherboard, which I'm not very keen on doing. So good, where is this one? Is this fine? Okay, so it is in place. Yeah, okay. So I feel like there's something underneath. I'm just gonna open the back side just in case there's the cables applying pressure, and it is the cables applying pressure, so I'm gonna have to just do it like this. Okay. Watch it, this case is gonna close like this. Maybe. Big maybe. Guess we'll see. So let's connect again. Small cables first. So, where do we have? I just took the case out of the speaker by accident. Okay, so we have HD LED there.
Speaker is in the way, so let's move this speaker. That's these two, now the speaker. And is this one, power. Power was there, there was another one. This one. Power plus, the power minus. Power LED. Minus and the power LED here. Now we have the normal power. Come on, get in. So I make sure I'm not breaking any pins or anything. And there's the one that we couldn't really reroute. Can connect this one. That's gonna be fun to connect as well. So this one goes here. And now this one is gonna be fun. So let's move this one here and here. And somehow it's gonna connect here. Oh, actually it wasn't that bad. Okay, so we're done, so let's just send this one through here. That's fine, that's all connected. We still need a SATA cable there. Just get a SATA cable. So I got the SATA cable, so we're just gonna connect it. So let's just connect it here so it's nice and even. So now we can go to work on it. You can see what I'm doing. And can't even grab the cable properly. It's done. Okay, and now I'm just gonna send it back from here. Let me just put this up. And we're gonna connect it. Just here. Okay, that's done. So this one, okay, we'll see. I have to sort this cable somehow. I'm gonna send this one as well through here. That's done, and we can keep it back here. Let's just finish assembling it, that, so we only have the graphics card to add now. that. It's in place. So it's here. So let's get these screws. Big fan of these cables running here. You can see a lot of cables. These ones are to go here. And here. Okay, it's connected. Can go through here, but then we still have these cables here. But there's only so much you can do. So let's take these off. That worked. Okay, and now let's hope that the glass actually fits there. Plastic on both sides. It kind of fits, but it's also touching. Okay. Alright, so let's just put this on for now. I'm not gonna take the plastic for now. I'll take the screws later and then take the plastic off after. For now I just want to put everything kind of back in place, because then we're gonna jump to the back of the computer and then we're gonna connect it and see how it looks overall, and then we'll take the plastic when we check that. As you can see, it's lifting off a little bit because it's touching that. It's okay. It could be worse. It could not close at all. So it closes. That's a good start. Happy with that. Right. So this part is done. So let's just go to the back. Let's just put it this way so you can see as well. So we need to connect this one. This one, let's see, you can connect it here in this chain that is here. And hopefully that's gonna be enough. Okay, let's connect it just in case it's not enough. So we're just gonna connect this. Or actually, you can connect everything just to make sure that it's all fully working. Mouse, keyboard, and HDMI. And the moment of truth. Let's see. Okay, sorry. Okay, so far so good. It's looking alright. The front doesn't seem. Does it have lights in the front? No?
They did before.
No, they did before, so maybe we disconnected something. So let's see. From the front are connecting to this chain, so either something is not connected properly, they are working now, or there's not enough power for everything. Here we go, there's not enough power for everything, so I need to connect this one to a different one like this, and that's exactly the reason why I wanted to turn it on before I sorted the cables, because these type of things happen. It's all working. All right, looking good.
Okay, so let's turn it off. And off. And let's sort these cables. So let's disconnect all of these. And let's put it like this for now. Okay, so let's just get some cable ties. Messy, just a bit. So let's use this one to try to go as it like this, and now we're gonna pull this cable here. Just put it this like this. It didn't go anywhere, and now I can actually just the cable here. Better, not ideal, but better. And this one to do the job. Now I'm more concerned is about this. There's a lot going on here, and the case might struggle to close like this. But we'll try. This one I'm not even gonna do anything. Actually, let me just set up the lights first. So I just need the power. Okay, on and off. So modes, we're gonna keep this mode, speed. This is the light. It goes faster or slower. The speed. Don't see any difference really. Okay, it's getting faster now. Okay, that's fine. So let's just switch it off now. Actually, like this. Right, now let's see if we can close it as it is. Or if I need to do some cable management that I don't really feel like doing. Okay. Oh, here it goes. It did. Okay, that was quite impressive. And too easy, to be honest, but I'll take it. I'll take it. This before it regrets. Okay, and now for the final product. Let's just clean up a little bit here. So now I'm gonna take this one off. Ah, that looks much better. And we're going to take these screws off.
Okay. So, look at these plates here.